slips. It's Bledisloe Cup Eve. How's the team feeling? I guess confident after 2 weeks of training?
Yeah, we've actually trained really well. The last week or 10 days have been pretty tough. So, we know what's in front of us. We know what we have to do. We're going to have to put in one hell of a shift to get a result. So, boys are prepared well. We're looking forward to it.
So it didn't seem like there was too many words up there just before alongside Artie.
It's because we were trying to smile for the cameras, mate. There's a lot of respect there. We've played a lot of rugby against each other. We're excited for the game, mate.
Melbourne this time last year, it was a bit in that one. Do you remember that?
Yeah, I remember it. Oh, it hurts. Like, it, you know, whenever you don't get the result, it's always going to hurt you. And I guess in the fashion that we kind of blew that game, makes it hurt a little bit more. So, you know, for us, hopefully, we can play a game which, it's on our terms. We don't have a referee come in and, decide it right at the end there. So, it was a great game to be a part of. We absolutely love playing in Melbourne. The crowd was unbelievable last year and we're expecting the same tomorrow.
Do you use it as motivation, that game?
I'm not sure it's motivation. I think, if you look at our last two recent games, that's pretty motivating. We've come off two pretty disappointing results, both in Africa and in Sydney. So, we're probably looking back to those games and trying to get better. We understand that we've got a new coach now. There's a new playing group, slightly different to the team that played last year here in Melbourne. So, it's hard to not shy away from the fact that last year was tough, but we're a new group now.
You were off at the time. I mean, you captained the team. You were off. Did you guys take lessons from that as far as leaders, about communicating with referees and understanding the management in the game?
In that aspect, yeah, we did. I think it's just about a bit of game smarts really back then. But as I said, mate, it's a new year. Ideally, we're in full control of what we're doing as players.
James, what have you seen on the training field in the past week that makes you feel you can turn this around?
There's been a lot of hard work, a lot of honesty. I guess a lot of bad habits that we've formed over the last 10, 20 years that we haven't been able to win the Bledisloe. So for us, we're trying to change that in the way we train, understanding what we're doing wrong, and then training it out of us. So. It's a bit of a work in progress at the moment, but we're confident we're on the right track for sure.
Different role for you this week, slips. Yep. As a finisher, what was the chat with Eddie about when he told you about that, and what is he telling the computer bringing those last 20-30 minutes?
Just a little bit of experience, I guess, to close out a game. Eddie's mentioned at the start of the year that he's probably going to use 5 captains throughout the year, and that's probably something that's not going to change. With HIA and injuries and that sort of stuff coming into the game in the past. Or recent history, so not much is going to change for me. My job around the team throughout the week hasn't changed. It's just about now supporting the guys that start, Alan, Tate, those boys who are going to lead the boys out initially in the game, and then you got the likes of myself, Whitey, Quade's on the bench as well. So there's a bit of age, a bit of experience there as well. So yeah, nothing really changes. Just where I play.
You guys done anything? Get on the MCG obviously with the game tonight, but have you done anything to acclimatise to try and understand what that environment would be like?
As in the stadium?
Or just the crowd, like the size of the
crowd? Not so much. We've been to the stadium throughout the week, and for a lot of us that was the first time we've walked into the G's, so it was being a fanatical sports fan, I absolutely loved it. It's huge. It's going to be a great atmosphere. Like, if I think back to Marvel last year, it was unbelievable. So to move over to the MCG and have a crack there would be unbelievable.
James, if your mates are excited to be playing at the MCG, what does it mean for an Australian to play on the MCG?
Oh, it's one of the world's greatest stadiums. So, for us, we're lucky to call it home. We've seen some sporting events there held in the past. And I guess you always look at those big moments in sport, and most of them are at the MCG. For us, we're extremely humbled. We understand how much the Melbourne public love their sport, and we want to make sure we put on a performance that they're proud of, but also ourselves. But we can't wait to get out there. We the stadium itself is unbelievable.
Does the slow history of the last 20 years weigh you down? Does it motivate you to turn it around?
Oh, I'll probably get asked that question every year. My first game was actually here in Melbourne against the All Blacks, and I got asked that question then. So it's one of those things that we're just going to have to understand. That's part of our history. It's been 20 years now, and as I said a little bit earlier, it's a new group, new coach. We got high endeavours to push forward and win the cup. So it's a two-horse race. The odds don't really stack up when you've lost 20 in a row. And that's on us as players, and that's something that we're trying to rectify.
Slips, as you mentioned, you want to win the cup, but you have two tough losses, and the All Blacks are coming off two big wins. Why should Australian rugby fans believe that this is the year that Qantas is coming out?
Mate, you're dead right. It goes back to what I'm saying. We're trying to build something. We've changed what we're doing in terms of staff, coaches. There's new players in the squad. Just like you look at tomorrow, we've got a new 5'8" who's going to lead us around. He's young, he's from Melbourne. So there's a different landscape to us. But in saying that, I'm not going to stand here and say we're the finished product, but one thing I'm going to say is we're going to work very hard to be.
Do you get any confidence? Like last year, you were written off as well, and then you come out pushing for all but 80 odd minutes. Does that give you any confidence knowing that you can turn it around?
Oh yeah, you take confidence from your recent games. And it goes back, like last year was a different group. So yeah, you can look into that as much as you want, but for us, we got humbled in South Africa, and we were disappointed in Sydney. So for us, we're looking at those two recent games under Eddie and the playing group that we've got, and we know we've got to be better. We let ourselves down, and as I said, we're trying to change some habits that have been formed over the last decade or two.
James, in terms of those habits, discipline seems to be a key one. There's been a stack of yellow cards. Has it been a key theme during preparations for this game?
Discipline is something I feel like I talk about a lot. I guess in our sport, the referee has a pretty hard job to referee the game, and for us, we always seem to be on the wrong side of that. And that's on us as players. We've spoken about it, but it's reoccurring, and that's probably the issue. But we've addressed it, we've trained it. We need to see that transfer into the game.
You prepared for the All Blacks to give you a bit of niggle to maybe suck you into a few cards?
No, I'm not expecting that. They're a team that, they want to win just as much as we do. So I'm sure it's going to be physical. There'll be parts of the game that get heated, but that's only natural. But I can't see them trying to niggle us into anything.
Eddie has won the cup, and he seems sort of quite boldy, quite fearless about the task. Does that kind of rub off on you guys at all?
Eddie's definitely a coach who says his mind. He's a lot different to what we're used to, and to be fair, we've really enjoyed that sort of approach. So, does it rub off on us players? I think so a little bit. But I think that's probably more of an individual playing question.
James, can you expand a little bit more about how important it is for Melbourne to be part of that rugby footprint in Australia, and obviously MCG being part of that as well?
How important Melbourne is?
Yeah.
It's a big part of sport in Australia. Not just rugby, but I think in general, every sport wants to play in Melbourne. And rugby union is no different. We absolutely love it here. Every time we play here, we play in some of the most passionate fans going around, and it's got a big footprint in our country for sport, and we want to be a team that's represented on the field in Melbourne.
And what does it mean to get out into the MCG? What do you expect to
do? As I said earlier, it's a dream come true for a lot of us. Like, a lot of us haven't even been inside the stadium. So the other day we walked in there and it's incredible. Like, I'm a Queenslander, so I grew up, at Suncorp Stadium, so it's a little bit bigger than that. But I think the biggest thing about the G is just the history behind it, and that's something that we all understand, and that's probably why we're so excited.
Did you try and get some footy tonight?
I'd love to. Maybe a few boys are.
Thanks, guys. Just